What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we are taking a look at this 2021 Dodge Challenger RT Scat Pack. This is, well, the medium version of the Dodge Challenger. It's like between the regular models, the RT, and the Hellcat, of course, with over 700 horsepower. So this features a 392 cubic inch V8 with 492 horsepower and 644 newton meters. So it's a little bit more powerful than the 380-ish horsepower V8 that sits in the RT, but not as powerful as a Hellcat. So I'm going to show you around it, show you a couple of cool things on the Challenger, and then we'll take it for a drive towards the Autobahn for an Autobahn blast. Now, if you want to see more of these US cars, these muscle cars, let us know in the comments. Make sure you're subscribed with notifications on so you don't miss any of our other videos, and like the video if you enjoy it because it really helps us out. You can also follow us on Instagram if you like for some behind the scenes footage at Autotop.nl. All right, so we'll do a walk around quickly because we featured the Challenger before, but I'm going to show you because I absolutely love the Challenger. I think it looks so cool, especially from the front. This front end is magnificent. It's so wide and open, and this really reminds me of like those old Challengers from the 60s. We do have a little air intake there and there. I think, yeah, and I think the Challenger is the most like retro looking muscle car you can buy right now. The Mustang and the Camaro are, I mean, they're cool, but I think this one is the most true to its like original form, and I really love that. Now, as you can see, we've got the wide body version, which means you get these arch extensions, which looks super awesome, makes it look like a resto mod. And this insane splitter down here, which is super pronounced. Yeah, it is a very, very good look. Now, we've got an RT badge right there. Road and Track is what it stands for. As I said, you've got an RT version, a standard version, which has a little less power and a smaller V8. This has got the 392 and it's got the Scat Pack badge on the side as well, which is super cool, this crazy bumblebee with wheels. Scat Pack actually dates back to the 60s, when that's basically a group name that Dodge invented in the 60s for their muscle car lineup. So it's a really cool reference to the olden days. Now, 20 inch wheels, very, very nice. Absolutely love these wheels. 305 section at the front. That is absolutely massive. And we've got Brembo high performance brakes behind that. Very cool vents as well in the hood. Intake there. And at the rear, we've got the same beautiful wheels and 305s again. So it's got the same size tires all round. Very, very nice wheels actually. Really like those. AEC is the company that brought us this car. They are the importer for Dodge and Ram in Europe. Thank you guys so much for taking the cars to us again. Really appreciate it. It's just a joy to drive these cars every time. I'm smiling all the way through when I drive these Dodges. It's so much fun. So at the rear, we've got the exhaust, which is a proper exhaust, as you can see. No fake nonsense. And a nice boot lid spoiler, which is like hollow plastic, but it looks super cool. And we've got the classic Challenger rear lights, of course. Now let's take a look at the engine. So there we have the 6.4 liter V8, as I said, with 492 horsepower, 644 newton meters of torque. 0 to 100 around 4.7 seconds. Stop speed 280, which is, you need a lot of space to get that, but it will go to like 265, 270, and then, well, it's basically over. But this engine is so freaking nice. That's 6.4. You have so much torque and grunt and beef, and it sounds amazing. It's just, oh, It's so cool. It's so cool to drive these big V8s. I mean, we don't really have them anymore in Europe, so I'm really glad that the Americans are still having fun over there. So, we'll start it up. Got a nice Scat Pack badge there with animation. That's just lovely. Now on the interior, let's close the door and get a bit of AC going because it is quite hot. Where's the passenger vent? Oh, driver vent, I need that one. So ventilated seats as well, very nice. Now on the inside, quite a nice interior actually. I have to say that the build quality of these Dodges is pretty good nowadays. This is all, what is that, leather? I don't think so, no. But it looks really good, it feels good. We've got a nice 392 Scat Pack badge over there and on the seats as well. They have fun with their names and logos and badges. I really like that. The steering wheel covered in leather, super soft, very nice. Pedal shifters behind that. And of course, we've got the T-handle gear lever here, which you can put into manual mode and features the correct order of shifting up and down. But it's just a nice thing to hold, bit classic, you know, classic muscle car. The seats, pretty good, I would say, nice and soft and comfy. Support, you know, you're a bit loose in the seats, but it's not bad, not bad at all. And some storage down here. And we've got the infotainment, which is also pretty good. It's very responsive, resolution is great. Yeah, nothing to complain really. Everything you need is in here. You can go to apps and to like the SRT dashboard. You can set up your line lock, your driving modes, your launch control, RPM. You can do everything in here. These are the driving modes, so track, sport, custom and auto. So yeah, really, really nice. Now, visibility in here is pretty poor. You've got those high doors, small windows all around, and you've got that horrible side view mirror that acts like a freaking looking glass into the past. It's such nonsense. So that one is normal. So that's a curved mirror, and this is a flat mirror. This, you can throw this away, literally. You only use that one and this one, and then you've got a rear view camera from the 1990s, which you can also use. But this mirror, I really don't get how people in the US maneuver with that thing. I mean, if I'm parking somewhere, I can't even see the thing I'm trying to park in. Okay, so we're going for manual and track mode, of course, and we're going to turn off traction control altogether because it's more fun. There we go. So first gear. And this thing picks up so quickly, and that's basically down to two things. It's a very, very good engine, and it has a throttle pedal that has been set up by someone who also tunes guitars and violins. It is so sensitive, it's ridiculous. It's always, you know, at the top of the throttle. So every time, I've been driving this car for a week and a half now, literally I've done this hundreds of times. You pull away from a traffic light and you're an asshole, because you just pull away like an asshole. There's no option, it's on off. It's pretty annoying sometimes when you just want to cruise around and behave like a normal person. It's very hard to do. But the thing sounds so good. Those US V8s just have something special. And I really, really love that this car is such a throwback to the old Challengers. So that goes for a lot of stuff. You know, of course that 6.4 V8. But also the seats, which are nice and big and soft. The car itself is nice and big and soft. The suspension is nice and soft. If you just leave the gearbox the TorqueFlite ZF 8-speed, which is amazing. If you just leave that in drive and cruise around, it is super comfy. And I think it's cool to see that they are really true to that old school muscle car feel. The Camaro and the Mustang have moved more towards like European sports cars, while this is still about having fun on the streets and on the drag strip. You know, you're not supposed to attack an Alp or a track with this car, even though RT stands for road and track. That's really not what it's for. It's just made to have fun with a V8. Oh, you do need a European gearbox though, because that improves this car so much. The US V8 with the EU gearbox is a freaking match made in heaven. Okay, so at the Autobahn, let's find out how it feels, because it is super nice and comfy. We're in track mode right now, so the most aggressive setting, but still it soaks up all the bumps. It feels super solid. And the V8 revs out to around 6,000 RPM. Of course, we also measured our 100 to 200 run, and the car did very well at 10 seconds dead, which is very impressive. We always say that if you do 10 seconds or less, you've got a quick car. Well, this is a quick car, and we really weren't expecting it to be that quick. It's performing very, very well. Now the top speed, I don't know if we can get close to that right now. It depends on the traffic, because you do need quite a bit of space to reach that, or if you can even reach it. But I have to say that I'm really impressed with how solid the car feels, and just the suspension setup, the chassis, everything just feels so nice. That's 266. It's quiet in here. Yeah, it's a pretty impressive car. It's a long way from like old muscle cars with drum brakes, 4-speed gearboxes, seats you would fall out of, but still capturing that essence, you know. The spirit of muscle cars is strong in the Challenger, and I really, really love that. And it's got some great Brembo brakes as well. Pedal feel is awesome. Stopping power is great. Now, we've been able to do 270 kilometers an hour GPS. So 280 top speed. I mean, you would need a lot of space to get there, but it's probably possible, theoretically. But maybe when we come back at night or something like that, it would be possible. But it's not bad. I mean, it's got 492 horsepower and that cut-off front end to push through the air. But it's a car that just breathes fun, you know. It's about enjoying the drive, enjoying the sound, the engine. And it's a bit of a lazy ass muscle car, and I really love that. I think that gives it, you know, its own place, its own slot within the current muscle car or pony car lineup. Oh, those are good brakes. It is. It's a pretty good car, really, all around. I don't have many complaints other than the throttle pedal, which is just ridiculously sensitive. The visibility is not great, but the car itself, the rest is very, very good. And if you think about the price, you know, in the US, this thing is around $40,000. A Hellcat starts at $70,000. So the value proposition of this Scat Pack is really good. Every time I drive a muscle car, I'm like, more people should buy this. It's just a really nice car. It's very comfy. It's much bigger than a Mustang or a Camaro. So you can actually fit a couple of adults in there. So I put one here for scale. He's thinking about stuff. It's a really, really nice car. So let's find out if the home stretch is empty. We might be able to get close to the top speed. Cornering to the apex, here we go. Soak up the bumps, lovely. Let it ride. There we go, to the outside. Most efficient line, shifting. As you can see, I mean, it's still accelerating a bit, but not by that much. So yeah. It's crawling right now, but
274 GPS.
Was that 274 GPS? Yeah. Okay, so 280 is possible. It's definitely possible, but you need a lot of space. That's the top speed conclusion. Some consumer advice for you by Auto.nl. Okay, so everyone in Europe, buy these cars because they're amazing and they're a lot of fun, and I would like to see more of them on the roads. That's it for the review. Fun is over. We crossed the border into no fun land and we're going to end it. I hope you enjoyed it. You can subscribe by clicking the big button in the middle. You can also check out this video on the right or check out this playlist of reviews on the left. Thanks for watching and I'll see you at the next one. Bye.